Hello YouTube, today we're going to be talking about my philosophy surrounding upper back training. So, for me, the upper back is probably the area of your body that can take the more volume, that can recover the fastest, and that you should be working the most. And thankfully, it is quite an easy body part to work. The issue with it is because it is so intricate and there are so many muscles that it can sometimes be hard to know what muscle you're targeting or not. And to know and to not be fooled, you need to be objective and need to focus on mind-muscle connection to know what is really being targeted. Because even though you're doing an exercise that is supposed to target a certain area of the back, chances are, if your form is not exactly how it should be, and if you have other muscles of the back who are stronger, then that area in particular might not get as much work as you think it's getting. So, what I personally do for upper back is, I train my upper back one way or the other every day. There will always be some upper back work in a training, and I train 6 days a week. What's going to happen is that the intensity and the volume that I apply to the upper back is going to vary. But for me, the staple of my program, and I think the staple of everyone's program, should be pull-ups. They can be body weight, they can be weighted, but for me, I have focused on body weight. Body weight pull-ups can be done every single day with no issues with recovery and wield amazing hypertrophy gains, as long as you switch the grip. For me, if you focus too much on one type of grip, you might get overuse injuries in your tendons and ligaments, but if you switch the grip around, there won't be any problem because you will not get a lat or a rhomboid injury from doing pull-ups, especially if they're just bodyweight pull-ups. So that's what is making up the bulk of the volume I apply to my upper back. I also do rows. I really like rows. I like strict rows. I like cheat rows. I like dumbbell rows. I do barbell rows. I do ring, Olympic rings, rows, all sorts of them. All that matters with the rows is that you find a variation that hits your upper back. If you feel it all in your arms and shoulders, you're doing your rows wrong, or you're not doing the right type of rows for you. I personally am a big fan of pullovers, especially dumbbell pullovers. I think they feel amazing for the lats. The type of isolation you can get and stretch on the lats you can get is unmatched in my opinion. As far as straps go, I used to rely a ton on deadlift and pull from the floor, but I've noticed recently that it's just not cutting it. So for around a year, I've been doing special isolation exercises for the traps, especially shrugs. And I've recently upped my game a bit. I will make a video about it, about how I plan to blow up my traps, with something completely simplistic. That's nothing, it's no fancy technique. And I will be explaining to you how, because you can apply it to your training too. It's very easy. As a whole, my upper back is a pretty good body part for me. It lacks width. That comes from genetics, but it also comes from me not training it smart enough for a very long time, where I don't have enough lats. So for me, I really focus on the lats with the methods I told you. And pull-ups for me, if done correctly with a slow negative, are amazing for the lats. As I said, very high frequency every day. On deadlift days, I will be focusing more on the traps. On arm days, I will be focusing more on the lats and on the rear delts. But the lats have always a very important part. I have certain days where I deload the upper back, meaning that I will do a minimum of a few pull-ups or a few leg raises just to get a good stretch, but I won't work them that much, and that's 2 days out of the 8 days of the program. So if you go into my place, you will see all of my days, what my program looks like. In the entirety of the program, there are 2 deadlift days that could be considered high intensity for the upper back. They are two arm days that could be considered medium intensity for the upper back. There is one bench day that could be considered high intensity, and there is one squat day that could also be considered high intensity. The others are all either non-existent training or it's very low. It's not focused on the upper back as much. I think that this is I usually don't like propping up my methods like the best methods, but as far as upper back goes, I really think you cannot go wrong with training it a lot. If you train your upper back only once a week in a split, you're doing it wrong. Even full body for me doesn't cut it, because if you do full body three times a week, you're still missing out on upper back gains. Your upper back recovers super fast. It can take on a ton of volume within the workout. So if there is a body part that you should really abuse a bit and push around, it's the upper back. Having a very strong upper back is also going to allow you to not end up all slouched forward. It's going to allow you to not develop shoulder impingements, so it's always a good thing. Notice that I talked about upper back. This is not a lower back video. I will be talking about the lower back in a different video. So that's pretty much my philosophy surrounding upper back training. I personally want a big, thick upper back because I have a wide waist and I need the back to be bigger and to basically catch the attention when I turn around. When I turn around, I need to have that beefy back so that the eye is not on the waist. So that is my video about upper back. Let me know how you train your upper back, what your philosophy is, what is your goal in terms of development, and what type of training you apply to get to that goal. Thank you for watching and have a good day.